good person to talk to about this. John Lonsky joins me now. John, look, more Americans now think, as we just heard, the American dream out of reach. That is sad. So what does that say about where we are as a nation, do you think?
Well, it tells us that inflation is running too hot. Mm-hmm. In addition, home prices are too high, along with elevated mortgage rates. It's a difficult situation for those trying to climb the income ladder from the bottom right now. It also tells us that perhaps the current administration is making a huge mistake by emphasizing income redistribution instead of focusing on realizing a faster rate of economic growth. It's through growth that those of lower to middle incomes are able to rise.
Very well put. All right, I'm going to move on, John. Take a look at this op-ed from the New York Times. It says, can Biden change the economic narrative? Paul Krugman wrote that, the Nobel Prize-winning economist. He argues that Biden isn't getting the credit he deserves for his handling of the economy. What do you say to that?
You know, we have to go back to inflation again. You know, sure, inflation has slowed from a high of 9% the middle of 2022. Recently, it's all the way down to 4%, but that still implies that over the past 2 years, inflation has risen by 13%. Prices today are 13% higher than they were in the middle of 2021. And the average American's not happy with that, in large part because wage growth has failed to keep pace with price inflation. And the unemployment rate remains very low. It's only 3.7%. But, you know, in order to have this dynamic, this sense of things getting better, you have to have a declining unemployment rate. And that does become quite difficult to do when it's so low already. To change the narrative, I think it's impossible for Biden because, again, he has to go towards a stronger growth message, and you can't do that when your hands are tied by regulatory efforts and the possibility of higher taxes.
Yeah, and let's not forget Paul Krugman famously said in 1998 that the internet wasn't going anywhere and had the same kind of impact as a fax machine. I also predicted that the global economy would tank after Donald Trump became president. He was very wrong on those two issues, so I don't pay too much attention to what he says. But I want to move on to this, John. Secretary Yellen heading to China tomorrow. Okay, she's trying to ease tensions and discuss trade. Is this going to help solve any of our issues with China, or do we need to take a continued strong approach to China, pushing back?
I think you have to take a strong approach. I mean, of course, the Yellen is being pushed by multinational corporations to try to normalize relations with China. After all, a lot of U.S.-based companies depend upon China for a manufacturing base. They also believe that the growth of the middle class in China provides them with an opportunity to expand sales overseas and profits overseas at some point in the future. But as it stands right now, you know, there are very tense relations between China and
the
United
States. Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new posts as you become part and parcel of the MCAT TV family. Please like and share MCAT TV. We love you all. Please support MCAT TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage project across Africa.